Hello everyone, this is Rick Grantham from Small Business Champion. We're coming to you today from our offices in Florida, so what you might hear in the background, if you hear like a screeching sound that's happening, that's basically crickets. It is cricket season here in Florida, so my apologies for anything you might hear in the background. It's just part of doing business in Florida. So what we're going to talk to you about today is a return on investment analysis and why this is so important for the small business owner. Now, a return on investment allows you to compare your cash outlay today of an investment decision. This could be an investment in new plant, new equipment, or a new service that you want to roll out. And we'll say you're a landscaping company and you want to buy a new lawnmower, you want to buy a new piece of lawn equipment. So what is your cash outlay today? Now, how does that also compare to, if your cash outlay today, well, how does that compare to the return that you expect to get a year from now, 2 years from now, and again, 3 years from now, up to, we'll say, 7 years or so? So what additional benefit do you expect to get? Also, what additional cost do you expect to get, or what additional investments do you expect to also happen over time, 1 year out, 2 years out, 3 years out? And using the same example here, if we're buying a new piece of lawn equipment, some of the benefits we may get is that we're able to do more yards, right? And therefore we can bring in more revenue. Some of the additional investment that we might have is there might be additional costs associated with gasoline or the additional cost to be able to actually do that many more yards, right? By having to have more employees and things of that nature. So at different points in the future, you're expecting different revenue and you're expecting different costs. And how does that compare to the cash outlay that you have today? Is this going to be a wise decision for you? Would it be a wise decision if it's a neutral decision for you if you have a 10% return? You could go either way if it's a 10% return for you, annual return. What if it's a 20%? Is that neutral for you? The reason that's critical is this analysis in particular allows you to play with something called cost of capital. And basically that's your break-even point on whether or not it's a good decision for you or not, on whether or not you should take the money and invest it in this solution versus investing it in another investment opportunity. Now, this analysis in particular also calculates net present value for you. So what that means is once you take into account your future revenue and your future expenses for 1 year out, 2 years out, and 3 years out, if you discount that all to today's dollars, so that you can compare it with the cash outlay that you're doing today, right? Because it's more valuable to have money today than it is to have it a year from now. We could all say that, you know, having money 5 years from now, you know, there's going to be inflation, there's going to be things of that nature, right? So bringing that all today's dollars so that you can compare that. So this analysis does that calculation for you, does net present value. Also calculates payback, your payback period. In this case, it calculates payback period in years. So from your initial investment, is it 1 year out before you get paid back, 2 years out, 3 years out? Exactly what is all that calculation? What does that look like for your best, for your business and for your investment decision that you need to make in your business? So in the next part of the tutorial, we're going to bring up the analysis. We're going to bring up the solution. We're going to walk you through it. We're going to help you navigate the solution. We're going to show you how to input your own business numbers so that you can do your own calculations and you can figure out whether or not the decisions you need to make for your business are profitable for you. So stay tuned for the next part of the tutorial. Hello everyone, this is Rick Grantham and welcome back to the Small Business Champion Bundle tutorial. So we walk you through the return on investment analysis. Now, as you open the analysis, the first thing you'll be met with is this welcome screen. Now, in the welcome screen, there's a few things you'll notice. First off, over here on the left-hand side, you'll see an opportunity to join the conversation where if you click different links, different things will happen for you. You can click to download a small business ebook that I've written. Our questions and answers, those are questions and answers related to a lot of topics in small business, including these tutorials. You'll also have the opportunity to join our communities on LinkedIn and on Facebook. And over here on the right-hand side, you'll also see text welcoming you to the community and showing you different ways that you can interact with us. You'll notice also if you try to double-click anywhere in here and try to, say, write in some text, you'll be met with an error message that says, hey, you can't do anything on this screen. And the reason you can is this is a protected screen, because there's nothing for you to do. There is no analysis on the screen. To get to the return on investment analysis, you can come down here to the bottom where it says return on investment, this tab, and we'll click on that. Now, when you click on the return on investment analysis tab, you'll come to a screen that looks pretty similar to this. If you scroll over to the right-hand side, the first thing you'll notice is another opportunity to join the conversation by getting the book or just joining us on LinkedIn or any of our different groups. You'll also see instructions on how to interact here on the left-hand side. You'll see instructions on how to interact and how to navigate through the template, but we're going to walk you through everything that's in the text here. So, over on the left-hand side, you'll see the actual analysis. Now, the analysis is separated into two major areas, or three major areas. The first one will go down to the bottom, which are your inputs. So you have here all of the different inputs that you would put in that would drive the analysis. As you move upwards, or you scroll upwards, you'll see there are different outputs. So based on the inputs that you've put in, there will be different outputs around cash flow, around the amount of discounted benefits that you would have. And then the final third area up here at the top are your measures. So first off, your return on investment. So what is your return on investment year one, year two, year three, etc., along with other return on investment measures such as net present value and your payback in years. So first off, the question you might have is, well, I see all of this, but how do I know which areas that I'm supposed to input numbers into exactly? Which ones do I have free rein over? So to do that, let's go over here to the right-hand side, and you'll see there's an opportunity to highlight the inputs. What we're going to do is select Yes from the drop-down menu, and in selecting Yes, what you'll notice is that a lot of areas light up blue. So the areas that light up blue that are now highlighted, these are the cells or the parts of the analysis that you can interact with that'll drive different parts of the analysis. For an example, scroll down to the bottom where the inputs are. You'll see here that even the titles over here are blue. What that means is input the benefit driver that's specific to you, that's specific to the business decision you need to make. And in this case, piggybacking on the example of a landscaping company, what are the benefits that we might have? It would be, we'll say, increased income. And our increased income in year one, in this case, we'll say it's going to be, we're going to have an increase of $5,000 as a result of this decision. And say year two, that might be $7,000. Year three, that might be $8,000. What you'll notice is as I'm putting in these numbers and pressing enter, the numbers up at the top here, the outputs are changing. So as I hit the enter button, you'll notice quite a few things updated in the calculations from your annual cash flow benefits to your discounted benefits as well. So with these, you can input all the different drivers that are specific to you. You'll notice that once you pull up the analysis, all of these will be zeroed out for you. So I have these pre-populated so you can see what a full analysis looks like once you've input all your numbers. But once you pull this up in the template, everything will be zeroed out so that you don't need to worry about any numbers that were there previously driving the analysis. You'll be able to start with a fresh slate. So in addition to all the benefits that you might get as a result of the investment decision you need to make in year one, year two, year three, and year four, you would also have an investment that you would make. Now you'll notice that in the benefits, year zero is grayed out, where in investment, it's not grayed out. And here's the reason. You're making an investment today that you're expecting to have benefits at some point in the future. Now it may just be 1 hour in the future. It may be starting one day in the future or 1 year in the future, but at some point in the future, you're gonna start to get a return, or your hope is you're gonna get a return off of the investment that you're making. And so in this case, we have this delineated into years or categorized into years. This would be from day one to year one, as example, all categorized into year one, but that's where you expect to get the benefit. And your goal of your net present value analysis up at the top is to figure out, well, year one, if money is more valuable to me now than it is in the future, how much do I have to discount that benefit that I'm going to get to make it equal today's dollars, the cash output that I'm putting out in today's dollars? So let's move back up to the investment piece. In year zero, or in this case today, the initial investment I make in this new piece of equipment might be $7,500. You see that changes the analysis. You would have noticed everything kind of updating here at the top. Implementation costs may be an extra $3,000. And we could input additional cost drivers if we chose to. So you would also, you're not only just making investments immediately, you may be making investments over the course of the first year, over the course of the second year. At the same time that you're getting benefits, you may be making additional investments as well. This is particularly true in software. You may have to pay maintenance costs or anything of that nature. So any of those sort of maintenance costs or additional investments that you're making. So you have the opportunity to show all of your benefits and all of your costs, all of your investments, not only immediately, but then over time over the next 7 years. So as you scroll up to the top now that you have these inputs, you'll notice that there's one other area that's blue. This is the cost of capital. And I talked about this a little bit earlier in the tutorial before we actually brought up the analysis. This is the point to where an investment decision is neutral for you, right? This is the point to where you've made a decision that it needs to have a certain return for you for you to move forward with the investment that you're going to make. So in this case, it will default to 15%, but you may decide that you need to get a 20% return for something to be a good investment for you. Or we'll go ahead and we'll put in a 5% return, just as an example, your cost of capital. You'll notice whenever I hit the enter button, which I haven't done yet, you'll notice net present value changes. I'm going to hit the enter button, and it went from about $3.5 million to $6.5 million. So what that's done is it's taken all of the benefits and all the investments that I need to make in the future, and now saying that every year that I'm going to move it closer to today, I have to discount that by 5%, because I would have expected to have gotten a 5% return on that investment had I invested it somewhere else outside of this investment decision. The analysis also calculates for you your payback in years. Now, in this case, the payback happens to be, in this analysis, happens to be 1 month. So lucky us on that. But however, you would be able to see exactly how that's calculating down here below. In your year zero, the amount that you went negative out of pocket to begin with, and your discounted benefits. And discount means once I've taken the future dollars and I've discounted to today's dollars, what does that mean? So your discounted cost, your discounted benefits, what does that mean? And finally, your return on investment. So your return on investment in year one, year two, year three, etc., is all here calculated for you as well. So at this point, I can start to play with the analysis and figure out, okay, well, I'm expecting a 25% return. That changes my net present value. And if my training costs aren't going to be $50,000, but they're going to be $500, and if I'm going to have no additional costs in the future, let's just go ahead and zero these numbers out. What does that do to my calculation? You see everything updates real quick. And my additional benefits, let's say my additional benefits here are all $0. Zero these out. Say, except for the $5,000 a year that I'm getting from year one, and I'm going to make that through year seven. So that's the value of this decision. So as I scroll up now, I can see, wow, net present value is positive. So this is something I would move forward with. I would expect that I'm coming out of pocket by $11,000 right at the very beginning, but I'll start to make that up over time. My cumulative benefit, I go positive in 2.2 payback years, which means I'm still negative $1,000 at year two, and then I start to go positive. And once I discount all of that to today's dollars, this is worth, this investment decision at a 25% cost of capital is still worth a $4,800 return. So that is your analysis. If you're getting ready to print this now, you can put highlights back to no to clean it up for printing. And as you come over to File, Print, as you would normally, this will all print out to one page, and everything would be ready for you. So this allows you to, if you're keeping track, this allows you to input different investment decisions, calculate return on investment analysis, calculate net present value and your payback, play with different scenarios without ever having to get an accountant involved. So this is perfect for the small business owner as part of your small business bundle. Thank you, and be a champion.